All right, thanks, Eddie, and thanks everybody for joining us here today. I know we're a couple minutes behind schedule, but I promise you that I'll get through my presentation before the provincial budget drops. I can't make a similar promise for the presenters after me, but at least I'll be out of the way by then. So I have the distinct opportunity and pleasure to talk today about clean electricity for the province of Alberta, and focus in a little bit on one initiative that we've been working on as a continuation from my presentation last year for those of you who had the opportunity to join us then. So I'm going to start off by saying that Alberta has a significant greenhouse gas challenge. On one hand, we know that we have an energy-based economy, and we want that economy to continue to grow and to thrive. But on the other hand, we know that greenhouse gas emission reductions are a significant challenge, and there's significant pressure locally and globally to reduce emissions. And if we look at Alberta's current climate change strategy, which is pictured here, there's a lot of things going on here. In many ways, this is a somewhat complicated slide, but there's a very simple observation that I'd like to make here. And that is, if you start at around 2005 or so, where the graph starts, and you look out to around the year 2030 and beyond, if we expect to meet and stick with the plan or the target path in the plan, we need absolute greenhouse gas emissions reductions. And that will increase, those reductions will need to increase as time goes on. So in the long term, the point number one is very simple. We need absolute greenhouse gas emissions reductions. Secondly, so we know that we need absolute greenhouse gas emissions reductions, and so the question is, where are we going to get them? And we've heard a little bit about that today. Paul had some really good comments about everybody needs to be part of the solution. We're going to need a contribution from all sectors of the economy. And if we look at Alberta's greenhouse gas emissions profile, we see that there are two industrial sectors that make up over 3/4 of Alberta's industrial greenhouse gas emissions. So not only do we need all hands on deck, so to speak, in order to meet very ambitious greenhouse gas emissions reduction targets, but there's no question that among these two sectors, oil sands, which we've talked a lot about today, and also the electricity sector, that those need to be part of the solution. So point number two is that not only do we need absolute emissions reductions, but we need absolute emissions reductions in the electricity sector. So if we drill down a little bit and look at the emissions forecast in the electricity sector, we see some really interesting things going on here, some really good work and some other interesting observations. First of all, we know that there are things going on, efforts underway to try and achieve greenhouse gas emissions reductions in electricity. We have now more than ever before in the province of Alberta renewable electricity attached to the grid, both on an absolute basis as well as on a percentage basis. We have more renewable energy now than ever before. We also know that there's a federal regulation that effectively mandates the phase out of coal over time, over the next 20, 30 years or so. And we can see in this graph, if we forecast the electricity emissions out to around 2050 or so, we can see some good attacks, in a sense, on the greenhouse gas emissions, particularly around the 2020 timeframe and the 2030 timeframe. As some of the major coal facilities come offline, we see some reductions in greenhouse gas emissions. But unfortunately, what we also see is that if we look at the long term, the forecast here, with the transition from coal to natural gas electricity generation, because demand continues to rise, we do not see long-term absolute greenhouse gas emissions reductions. So point number three is that the current trajectory will not get us to where we need to go, will not result in absolute greenhouse gas emissions reductions. So if we sum up this challenge in a nutshell, first of all, we need absolute reductions in electricity. Secondly, we know the current trajectory will not get us there. Now, I don't want to go as far as to say that this is a crisis, as Warren might have said, but what I will say is that it's clear that sustainable, clean electricity solutions are needed for the province of Alberta. So some of these solutions may come in the form of policy drivers, but certainly some of these solutions need to be in the form of technology. And that's where AIES comes in. Our role, as we've heard from many presenters today, our role in the area of, specifically in the area of electricity I want to talk today, is to identify the critical technology gaps that are needed in order for us to reach our targets and to meet our goals. Technology gaps as well as knowledge gaps. And to try and address those gaps through the demonstration, development and demonstration of new technology. As an organization, we're also quite uniquely positioned as an innovation system as a whole for Alberta, but very specifically AIES is quite uniquely positioned due to our relationship with both industry and the government of Alberta to use the technology development demonstration projects that we have to help inform government policy. So that's another role that we have. Specifically in the area of clean electricity, we have a number of different initiatives going on, and we have I put a few of the key initiatives up here, one of which you'll hear about right after my presentation from Dr. Maureen Cola in the area of waste management, waste to energy, or this notion of landfill-free Alberta. Another in the area of renewable energy technology development. So this is things like wind technology, wind power, solar, geothermal, bioenergy, hydro, anything in the renewable energy area is something that is of interest to us as an organization. We also have a really exciting initiative going on right now, being led by a couple of my colleagues in the Calgary office, Duke Duplessis and Nevin Simulai, who you heard from earlier, involved in technology road mapping, understanding, and this really gets back to the first bullet on the slide, trying to identify and understand what precisely those gaps are and where we need to focus our efforts in order to address those gaps. And one of my favorite topics, and this is what I'm going to talk about for a few minutes here, is the notion of electrical energy storage for the integration of renewable energy. So I'll spend a couple minutes talking about that specifically. So the idea here is to use energy storage to accelerate the deployment of renewable energy. We have vast renewable resources in the province of Alberta. We have very strong wind resources and strong solar resources, largely concentrated in the south. But we know those resources are by and large intermittent. And we know there's a fundamental disconnect between intermittent resources that are switching on and off, ramping up and down, and the electricity system where power needs to be available upon the flick of a switch. So energy storage, we feel, and it's fairly widely recognized, that energy storage is one of the solutions that can help to bridge that fundamental disconnect between intermittent resources and a stable, reliable electricity grid. So within the area of energy storage, we have three primary focus areas. The first is on demonstration projects. We think that, as with any different technology area, the very first grid-scale demonstration project will be absolutely critical in terms of moving the area of energy storage forward for the province of Alberta. Secondly, knowledge gaps and informing policy. We've got a number of initiatives in this one. We're working on one really exciting project right now in partnership with CCEMC and Solus Energy Consulting that's really going to drive down to the question and give us a very deep understanding of the relationship between deployment of energy storage in the province of Alberta and enabling of greenhouse gas emissions reductions for the electricity system and the energy system as a whole. And then the third area is technology development. And it was under the banner of technology development that I had the great pleasure of standing here in this same position last year and announcing a call for proposals. As an organization, our board of directors had allocated $2 million for energy storage call for proposals seeking the next generation energy storage technologies to enable acceleration of adopting intermittent renewable electricity onto Alberta's grid. So we put this out late last year. It was announced in November at Tech Talks 2014, and we had a tremendous response to this call for proposals. By the deadline, which was at the end of January, we had received more than 50 proposals, and more than we had expected to receive, some very exciting proposals. And in the end, we as an organization approved six very exciting projects to go forward. These projects are shown here and represent a diverse spectrum of different types of energy storage technology. And if you layer these on top of the other initiatives the ongoing initiatives within AIES in the area of energy storage, it represents an even more diverse and robust portfolio of energy storage technology development projects, pardon me. I want to take just a couple brief minutes to highlight a couple of these projects. The first one is a local project here in Calgary. We've partnered with a professor named Ted Roberts at the University of Calgary, who has a very strong background in the area of flow battery development. And the idea with this project, so flow batteries, we know, have some very attractive properties when it comes to electrical energy storage. But unfortunately, right now, they're not cost competitive. So the idea with this project is to take a fundamental look at both the materials and the chemistry of flow batteries in order to try and percolate upward into commercial technologies and create more cost competitive and next generation flow battery technologies. So that's one of the projects that we're working on right now. Second project I want to highlight is with in partnership with a company called Unify Energy, but also in partnership with the technology developer here is a company called LightSail Energy. And this is looking at a well-known energy storage technology that's called compressed air energy storage. I think most people are familiar with this notion. When there's excess electricity available, when the wind is blowing and the sun is shining, you use that electricity to compress air. And then when electricity is needed, when the wind isn't blowing, you release that compressed air through a turbine generator and put the excess put that electricity back onto the grid where it's needed. But what's unique about this project and what's interesting about the technology here is that one of the shortcomings of compressed air energy storage, which has now been tried and tested, is that it suffers from fairly low overall efficiencies. And by and large, the primary reason for that is because there's thermal efficiency losses in the heat that's generated upon compression, and then the heat that's required to be added upon expansion when you have to run the expanded air through a turbine generator. And so in this project, Unify and LightSail are working on a solution they call regenerative air energy storage. And effectively what that means is they have a unique thermal storage and exchange capability that enables the heat upon generation to be used in expansion as well in order to improve the overall efficiencies. So this project or this technology through this project will be demonstrated at the megawatt scale in a pilot stage project. The last project that I want to really briefly touch upon is another local company here in Alberta. So this is TransAlta, also in partnership with Tesla. I'm sure many people are familiar with or have seen the announcements in the past year about the Tesla's stationary energy storage technology. The Powerwall is the one that you can put in your home. But at a larger scale, we've partnered with TransAlta and Tesla to pilot test at an existing site in Alberta Tesla's world-class lithium-ion energy storage or battery storage technology. As I said, this will be located at the pilot scale at an existing site in the province of Alberta. So that's just a brief overview of a couple projects. But what I will say is these projects are now underway. We're very excited about these projects. We're very excited to see what the results of these projects will be and the impacts that they can have on Alberta's electricity grid. But we also know that this isn't it. There's much more than just a handful of energy storage projects that are needed in order for us to meet the goals that we have in electricity. And so we, as you've heard very much today, the theme of collaboration and partnerships, we work on a partnership basis. And so we look very much forward to working with the folks in this room and outside of this room on exploring the future opportunities for more initiatives in the area of clean electricity. And we hope that if you have some ideas, you'll come talk to us. Certainly, please feel free to visit our website, but even better, please feel free to come and talk to us in person. We're here today, but my contact information is here. I welcome your thoughts, your ideas, and your emails. And so thank you very much for your attention today. Thanks, everybody. And since we have accidentally, strategically, no time for questions, I will take this time I have the distinct pleasure to introduce my colleague, Dr. Maureen Kola, who has the opportunity to talk about landfill-free Alberta.